of my range of dyes. I like having lots of colours to choose from. I've got a mix of landscapes, jacquard, and dharma dyes. I love the landscapes for their amazing range of colours. They have probably more colours, I think, than other dye producers. This is just a small sample, really, of what they've got. They've got several different series of colours, and they're all stunning, absolutely beautiful. A lot of subtle colours, a lot of variation, lots of different reds, for example. The jacquard dyes, I tend to buy the basic colours, purple, green. I've got the hot fuchsia there. I don't think you can go without hot fuchsia in your collection. Let's see, I've got some blues. My dharma dyes, I love these because they have things like electric violet and safety orange is incredible. And of course the fluorescent lemon is the most amazing yellow. It's absolutely bright neon, and even though it's a bit much on its own, it's incredible when you mix that with other colours. So I do mix my dyes quite a lot to get the results that I want. So it's good to have a range. If you don't want to have as many dyes as I have, if you want just to start off with three or four colours, I would strongly suggest you get, rather than a red, yellow, blue, I would go for a fuchsia, a sapphire blue, and a teal blue, and or an aqua, and a neon yellow. You could also get, if you wanted an extra yellow, a sunflower yellow as well. But these ones are the ones that will mix with the brightest colours and give you pretty mixes. They're guaranteed to mix up together nicely. I've started out with my wool soaking. This is just soaking in just tepid water with some vinegar in it. I probably put in a big splash of vinegar and enough water to cover it. So I don't use this as a very precise science. You kind of get a feel for it as you go along. This fibre is a Corriedale blend, and I'm going to drain this because we're doing low immersion dyeing and I don't want to have too much water left in it. So I've split my fibre up into three fairly even amounts because when I'm blending I want three different colours to choose from and to blend together, and I've got enough bits and pieces in my stash to add an extra little bits of pops of colour if I want it. I've just spread this fairly evenly across the bottom of the saucepan, so that's ready to have some dye. I've got no extra water in this, I just let this drain, but it's quite wet, so it's ready for the dye. Now I need to choose my colours. Now sadly I have run out of my bright aqua, which I really like. My first pot is going to be the blue, the blues. One of the keys to dyeing for blending is to create quite rich colours to start with. And I'm just going to pour all of that over my fibre. And if I tip this, it will pull up so I can tap the fibre down into it. This is a particular fibre that does not want to soak up the dye like a sponge, so I really need to encourage it. And that also means opening up underneath the areas and just checking that the dye is soaked right through. See if you can see in there. Quite a bit there, so I'll just encourage it around a bit more. Now the thing with low immersion dyeing is it means you can actually put several colours into the pot at once and they won't really mix up. I want to keep my blues quite, not separate, but I want them to be clearly different blues. I don't want to have them all mixed together, which is why I'm doing this low immersion. So Now I'm going to mix up another blue, and let's see what I've got. I have got Landscape Sky. Now Landscape Sky might be a little bit close to what I have already with the Sapphire, but let's have a look. If it's too close, what I'll do is add another colour into it. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to alter this a bit. Maybe it's a little bit less navy, but I want it to be a bit more distinct. And this is where it's not very scientific. I'm actually just going to add a little bit of Kingfisher. Okay, now it's looking, I don't know if you can see that, but you will once it's on the fibre. So I'll have a good stir up. Spots on the fibre. Okay. Now I'm just going to pour this on the other side. You saw I put most of the blue on one side. Now I'm going to put this on the other side. I'm just going to tip that in. Okay, now there's plenty of liquid in there from the dye itself. Quite a teal blue in comparison. It's really pretty, actually. So that's ready to go. So I'm just going to light this up. There we go. I'm going to turn down pretty low. Gas is quite instant, quite hot. It's the best thing, I reckon, for dyeing. I'll put that quite low. And if I think I've got too much dye in there for the amount of fibre, I can put more fibre in and again press it down. And I'm going to put the lid on, because what happens when you've got it covered is that it will steam, and that steam will circulate through and it will set the top of the fibre as well as underneath that's in the liquid. So I'm going to leave that. If you can measure it, 80 degrees Celsius is the temperature you want to get it to. That is what helps the dye set into the fibre. And the hotter you get it, the more vibrant your colour. So if you're finding that your colours are not as vibrant as you expect, you might not be getting it hot enough. But then you don't want to boil it. It's got to be below boiling. If it boils, it risks felting quite badly. So I actually don't have a thermometer here, but I used to. You always check my temperature, so make sure it gets to 80 degrees. You can see the color will actually mature as it heats, and it will become more vibrant even just in the pot. You'll definitely see it. So, and I'm going to let that go for about, I don't know, they say about half an hour, but I usually do about 45 minutes, and then I leave it in the pot to cool. So we'll come back when it's finished doing its thing and I'll show you what we've got. You're just going to scatter this over the top. Because I don't want it to take over the colour of all the fibre. So now that the fibre is already hot in here, because it's been heating for a couple of minutes, started steaming. Now it's hot and I put that violet on there, it should just take up into the area that I've put it and not spread out and blend. So now we're going to leave it a bit longer. I'll clean up my stuff. So here's my pot of blue. It's a bit hard to see with all the steam coming out of it because it's cold out here, so it's quite steamy. This has been sitting here for about just over half an hour, and I'm quite happy with how the colour's looking. I'm going to let this cool now and then rinse it. On my next pot I wanted to do some alternate colours rather than the basic primaries. So what I've got in here is actually something called Moss from Landscapes, and Dusk, also from Landscapes, and the softer colours, not the really bright vivid colours that I would normally do, but I thought this would be nice to blend with some of the other colours that we've got. So I'm going to make one pot with three different colours. And just for something a little bit exciting, I'm making my third colour here, some hot fuchsia. This is a dharma dye. Just going to pour that in. So I've got my fuchsia sitting in there. Because this is low emulsion, I can put these dyes next to each other and there's not going to be too much bleeding between them. I don't mind if there is some because I like where the colours meet. You often get some pretty neat combinations and blends. For me, that's usually the best part of the pot, is where the colours have met each other in the fibre. So it's wet enough to do that, but not so wet that it'll spread everything right through the pot. You can still see down here there's no actual liquid. If I tip it, you can just see it start to fill up that gap. But it's really just enough liquid to have the fibre nice and wet without anything extra for it to float around in. So this is the three colour pot I'm just rinsing out, and I'm liking hairs like this. Really pretty colours come through. Lots of depth. I'm just rinsing it out and I didn't let it cool down completely. Normally if I had the patience, I'd leave it overnight to cool down, which also helps that dye just to sink in a lot better. But at the moment it's actually just still hot from the pot. So I'm running hot water through this, about the same temperature as the fibre, so it doesn't shock it and felt it. And it's a fairly non-felting fibre blend anyway, so I'm not too worried, but I'm just gently running the water through it. I'm not agitating it at all. It's coming out clear. So I'm quite happy with that. And I'm going to put it in the centrifuge and spin it out and bring it up to dry. Now for my blending, I have two semi-solids, the yellows and the blues, and I also have the moss, the dusk, and the fuchsia from my third pot, and all the interesting shades that I got where those colours met each other in the pot. The advantage of dyeing semi-solids for blending is that you get some really rich and dynamic colours even when you just blend that one pot together with all those beautiful, gorgeous shades of blues and greens and reds. But when you blend them together and to make new colours from them, you get a deep richness that you wouldn't normally get from just leaving them as dyed fibres. Really, really exciting to do, and I hope you enjoy colour blending with your dyed fibres.